Okay, let's read. So the message, every time I come out, I have to. Because I'm not only address you, I'm address the whole world. Because I know the impact of this ministry to the whole world. And so therefore, I must recognize them, not only pray for you, pray for my country, but the whole world. When you look at the last year and 2 years, everything we said here came to pass. And it's still on now. But let me just read about Southern Africa. So, and I want to tell you, Southern Africa, I'm part of you. Just as I'm in Nigeria, I'm Southern Africa too. So therefore, we are going to pray, and I will stand praying all the time, putting it on the table, every time, all the time. And so once we know this, I think the battle has been won. So that's it. Okay, Southern Africa. So I wanted to mention the name of the country, but I know how sensitive you people are. You know, I have been in your midst for many years, and I know the way you people handle my case. You people are very sensitive. They don't, I mean, I think I need to talk in parable this time. I will talk in parable. When God gave me a direct answer that, Mr. So-so-so, this is what is going to happen, I will ask God the parable how to present it. Because it's like you people don't want straightforward truth, but you want me to, I mean, bug the word, put it in package, and you can begin to think of what this man means by all this. So this is why I say Southern Africa. I'm supposed to measure each country in South Africa, Zambia, Botswana, Zimbabwe, just name all this country one by one. But I now put them together, Southern Africa, because people are very sensitive. If I now say this country, then no. So let him pray. Start by, first of all, Southern Africa, if I may talk to South Africa, the currency that is going up, down, will soon be stable. It's just a force, but it will come to stable. The currency going up, down, up, down, up, down, it's not a permanent problem. It's just occasional problem, and it will stable. It will be stable. So that is the currency. Now, let's go to this way. Pray against the same thing when I was talking last meeting about scarcity and the shortage of food. There will be little rain. I'm talking to Southern Africa. There will be little rain at the wrong time. You know, when rain fall at the wrong time, it cannot be benefit to the crop or farmer. It's better not to even fall at all than to fall at the wrong time. That is, there will be little rain at the wrong time, which is not good for farming. Many farmers will be discouraged. That is Southern Africa. And when I say Southern Africa, the whole thing will shoot from South Africa. Are you with me? So many farmers will be discouraged. God, there will be little rain. And that little rain will now come at the wrong time, which is not good for farming. It will come at the wrong time. It's not good for farming. Now, in that vision, I was asking God, what is the way out? What can we do this year in Southern Africa and majorly in South Africa? So the Lord showed me that government should be encouraged by building dam. They should be able to invest on dam. So I don't know, I'm not a farmer, but they should be able to invest on dam, building dam and irrigation mechanism, using available water from the sea, this will also affect power supply. You see, power supply will become epileptic. And why epileptic? As time goes on, it will be very, very serious. Epileptic means today, it's not tomorrow. It may be very serious. Not only that, health care. Yes. If I may read again, I started by mentioning South Africa. Their currency that go up, down, after prayer, I ask God, what is this? It's not going to be a permanent issue. It is just an occasional trouble. It's just come for a while. Soon it will be stable. Soon it will be stable. But the challenge is not a issue to bother about. The major challenge is this. There will be little rain at the wrong time. Little rain at the wrong time, which is not good for farming. Many farmers will be discouraged. So discourage me, many will abandon, many will, it will really affect. So now I was asking the way out, and this was showing me. Government should be encouraged by building dam, and I don't know anything about dam, an irrigation mechanism, using available water from the sea. And I was asking, what sea? I can use the sea has salt. Where? There's what they can do about that. So because so that it will not become so serious, then we begin to think of what is the way out for this. I will type this out, I'll send it to the authority with them. Okay. This also will affect power supply and healthcare. That is, power supply will become epileptic. That is sign. And I don't know why, how come about that. Now, this will now tempt Southern Africa. One, the temptation that this will bring. Listen to the temptation. Government should be careful not to surrender most of their industry to the foreign countries. By the time things stable, and you have surrendered most of your company to the because of challenges of this and that, the country will become a hostage. These are the first temptation I saw in the vision. I want to read again. Temptation that this challenge will bring, by the time all this started, little rain, wrong time, no farm, no money, no food, no. They'll say, let's call the government and order. Government should be careful because this situation is temporary. It will be over towards the end of the year. Not this year, towards the year. By August, we begin to see things change. But they should not be tempted to surrender most of their industry to foreign country because of the challenges which will come and go. By August, we begin to see fading away of the challenges. We often come out of the challenges stronger, and they will come out of this challenge very, very strong. Very, very strong. Write it down. It is challenging, but they will come out of it very strong, and they will become strong nations, country. They will come out of it. But I'm just trying to summarize this. There are many things I cannot say here because I've been very, very careful because you people are very sensitive to the way you people will go about it. I don't know. Okay? This is why I'm trying to summarize the whole thing. Okay? Yes. This one is very peculiar, very sensitive. I have been thinking of how to present it so that they will not misquote me. My dear press, my dear Kolli Press, because we are two, we are pressmen. Mala TV is one of the most famous and popular all over the world. We are pressmen, my dear press, my dear colleague, so that they will not misquote me. I've been very careful. This one I'm about to say, just put it the way I'm saying it, but it's idiom. I'm not going to open it more than that. It's very, very, very sensitive. Ending of February to April, a very peculiar month in the Southern Africa region, sub-region. I will not say more than that. So me, they have to be steadfast in prayer. Ending of February to April. Then when you say ending of February, that the ending of February to April, a peculiar month in the Southern Africa sub-region. Let us observe prayer session in the beginning and the end of April, month April, that is from ending of February to April. Let us observe prayer session, the end of April, to the end of April. This month, the prayer session for the leaders. Okay, I will leave it there. If you want me to read. Ending of February to April, a peculiar, I changed the word here. I don't want to use the word I wrote here. I don't want to use it. When I'm reading, the Spirit of God says, no, change this letter. This letter here is exact letter, but the one I'm saying now is just a sweet word. Because the way we are going to look at it, but the letter here is different from what I'm telling you. The word peculiar is not the word peculiar here, it's a different word. In the Southern Africa sub-region, let us observe prayer session in the beginning and the end of the month for our leaders. I will let you know of further message as they are revealed to me. I will continue because I am part of you people. So like there's no enough time. We have East Africa there, which I want to read. When I read, you just write me, I'll put it on the internet. We are all living, we are not running anywhere. So that will confirm where, I mean, the where TB, the whom TB Joshua is representing. Okay. Once again, concerning the South Africa currency that is 14, that is up, down, epileptic in either rise, fall, it will be stabilized. Quote me. Okay, that's it. So I will want to print it. I decided not to type it because I tried to look for some word to use. So, and I'm going to send it to the authority by the grace of God. Okay. So now, we continue next week because there are many issues to be attended to here. So, continue Nigeria again. There are two, three things which I did not say about Nigeria, which I want to, address you on. When I was praying, I saw one thing. One of the minority parties, which I don't know, will be lifted up and will be reckoned with. Let us pray for God's love and unity in Nigeria. That is, if I may, one of the minority parties will be lifted up and will be record with that, it will be, they will record with it. And why this a party will be lifted up and will be record with. Let us pray for love and for unity in the country. Love and unity will stop it. If there's no love and unity, I'm seeing a minority party lifted up. Yes, the other one, the agriculture which I talk about in Nigeria. Listen to that. We have to pray for the minister of, in charge of agriculture. When I was asking, the girl, you asked her to go to agriculture. Well, how do we go about this? Okay, the Lord showed me the minister in charge of agriculture that we should pray for him, for God to sustain him, give him enablement and sustain him. Mm-hmm. Because much is expected from him. I have to mind that statement. Pray for the minister in charge of agriculture for God to sustain him. The New Year Eve, I mentioned North Korea. I know many people heard me when I mentioned North Korea. You know, the second day you hear what the man said on CNN. You know, I say we have to pray for the president of North Korea. That is New Year Eve, I said it. The second day on CNN, that is New Year, he said if you talk bad of him, he's ready to go for, to war. He said his message for the New Year is war. I say just pray for the North Korea. The reason why I'm saying it, I'm seeing an arrow from there. And it will affect the world, if not section of the world, a narrow from there. So let us live at peace, because the war we are fighting already, both in Syria and other, is still there. We cannot afford another one again. It will end the whole war. The whole war will be in confusion. No. New Year Eve, I said, please pray for the president of North Korea, because I said I will put more light, because what I saw, there's some weapon there you don't know, the world does not know about. If they throw that arrow, there will be confusion. Remember, there's fight everywhere. Adding this one to the fight, it means there will be confusion all over the world. So, I think the issue of Syria, I'm seeing them begin to talk of reconciliation. But the month of that, I think I'm going to read it for you people. Yes, for a while they could not locate the president there, for a while. But I want what, when, and how is in the morning. I'm going to read the book because I want to maintain the time. And I was telling my people that, hey, we will close earlier than before today. I think we are working towards that. Since the card is in my pocket, this is your weapon. So let's go and look for the card. I mean, what else again? I said, this is your weapon now. Oh, what I'm saying, you are not even listening. You are looking at the card. You are looking at the car in my pocket. All what I'm saying, you are not listening to me. Your heart is yearning for this car. Your heart is saying, all we are saying, give us one car. Okay, thank you. I think, come on, help me. So I will not be able to, we have the order. I'm going to read, probably I'm coming out on live program on Tuesday. I will read the other section of the other nation all over the world. Yes, because the situation with Arab nation will increase, and the tension will be very much. So I'm trying to bring, what is the cause of this tension? Why all this tension? Why all this? There will be so much tension. So what can we do? So thank you very much. I want to leave you for a while. Let's praise his holy name.